not help in movement. Until then, we have just learnt. Okay. Like Atwang, even in snail also.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Please stop telling good mornings now. Okay. Already, Paras is waiting. Right. We have learned that Atwang doesn't have bones. In the same way, even snail also doesn't have bones. In our body, both bones and muscles together cause movement. Whereas in earthworm and in snail, only muscles play their role for causing the movement. So in snail, there is a strong muscular foot in the under its head. Okay, in the snail, there is a strong muscular foot under its head. This muscular foot makes wave-shaped movements by its contractions and expansions, because muscles contract and expand and cause the movement. And the muscular foot present under the head of the snail, it makes wave-shaped movements by its contractions and expansions. And the same muscular foot releases a slimy mucus. Some of you have asked in the last class, while snail is moving, a line-like thing is formed at on its backside. What is that? This is nothing but the slimy substance that is released by the muscular foot. This slimy substance helps the smooth movement of the snail, because the slimy substance or the mucus, it reduces the friction on the moving surface of the snail. So only some people say that snail can walk without getting hurt on even the sharp edges also, right? So before start making its movement, the muscular foot will come out of an opening in the shell. Then snail moves in a wavy motion caused by the muscular contractions of the foot. Snail moves slower as compared to an earthworm. So both earthworm and snail both move slowly, but when compared to earthworm, snail moves much more slowly, right? Okay. Thank you.
allowed a view to ourselves. Sir, what is this chapter?
This body movement chapter only, sir. Right. So in snail movement, in snail, as already said, bones are absent. There is only a muscular foot under its head. This muscular foot, it makes wavy movement or wave-shaped movements by its muscular contractions and expansions. This causes movement. A slimy substance is released by the muscular foot, which reduces the friction while the snail is moving, so that snail can even move on sharp edges also. Like at the edge of a blade also, snail can move like that, people say. Right? I have not seen it, but people say like that. And when compared to the movement of earthworm, the movement of snail is slower. Okay, it is slower than the movement of earthworm. Right? Then let us discuss about the movement of cockroach. Okay. Cockroaches are called nocturnal animals, means night active animals. Right? When lights are off during night time, they become more active. Cockroaches, they can walk, they can climb, and they can even fly. See, three different types of movements the cockroaches can exhibit. What are they? Cockroaches can walk, cockroaches can climb, cockroaches can fly also. The body of cockroach has two portions. Okay. Downside the head, the body of the cockroach has two portions. The thoracic are top portion and abdomen are down portion. The body of the cockroach is covered with a hard outer skeleton. The outer skeleton of cockroach is made of different units, and these are joined together. Like how our bones are joined together, in the same way, the outer skeleton of cockroach, which is made of different units, those units are joined together. The joints of outer skeleton permit the movement of legs in cockroach. The cockroaches are having legs. So far, in earthworm and snail, we did not see any legs-like structure, whereas in cockroach, legs are there. And these legs movements are allowed by the joints of outer skeleton. And cockroaches, they have how many pairs of legs? They have three pairs of legs. And these legs help in walking. And I said cockroaches can even fly also. There are two pairs of wings attached to the thoracic or the breast portion or top portion of the cockroach. And two pairs of wings are there, na? One top pair wings, one downside wings. The top pair wings are opaque and thick. They do not help the cockroach in flying. Whereas the downside wings, they are transparent and thin, using which the cockroach can fly. And then why the top pair wings are there, which are opaque and which are not used for flying? The top thick or opaque pair of wings, they help or they protect the flying wings. Cockroaches have specific muscles for legs and wings separately, using which legs will move as well as wings will move separately. The muscles near the legs move the legs for walking, and the breast muscles move the wings when the cockroaches fly, right? Okay.
Sir, when will you send the seventh chapter note, sir? Excuse me, sir. When will you send the seventh chapter note, sir?
Shall I send today? Shall I send today?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, send it today, sir. It has not come, sir.
So what type of animals that the cockroaches are? Cockroaches are night active animals. Night active. Night active, it is also called nocturnal. Nocturnal animals. Right? So when the lights are off, during the dark time, cockroaches become active. Cockroaches exhibit three types of movement: walking, climbing, and flying. They walk, climb, and fly. Cockroaches can walk, climb, and fly. Right? Under the head of the cockroach, two parts are there. Under the head of the cockroach, two parts are there. So, make a cockroach. Upside down, you can see these parts. You can see these parts. If you make the cockroach upside down, you can see these two parts. So this part, this is known as thorax or breast. And this part is known as abdomen. So this is top part, this is bottom. So under the head of the cockroach, there are two portions: thorax, the top part; abdomen, the down part. And the body of the cockroach is covered with hard outer skeleton. The outer skeleton of cockroach is made of different units which are joined together. So cockroach has hard outer skeleton and several units are there. In cockroach, hard outer skeleton is there, in that several units are there that are joined together, and the joints of outer skeleton permit the movement of legs in cockroach. Right? The joints of outer skeleton they permit movement of legs in cockroach. So one point we have to recollect from snail. In snail, there is outer skeleton. What is the outer skeleton in snail? Shell. Does it help in movement? In snail, does outer skeleton help in movement?
No, sir.
No. In snail, outer skeleton, it does not help in movement. In cockroach, outer skeleton, it helps in the movement. The joints of outer skeleton permit the movement of the legs. Cockroach has three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. Three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. Cockroach has three pairs of legs and two pairs of wings. And all three pairs of legs are used for walking. Whereas out of two pairs of wings, only
downside pair of wings are used for flying. Only downside pair are used for flying. And the topside wings are used to protect the downside wings. The topside wings are used to only protect the flying wings. And cockroaches have specific muscles for legs and wings separately. The muscles near the legs, they help the legs to move. The muscles near the breast, they help for the flight, for the flying. Cockroach has specific muscles for walking and flying. The muscles near the legs, they help for walking. The muscles near the breast, they help for flying.
Okay, we'll meet in the next class.